कॉलर में लगा लीजिए, इसको जेब में डाल लीजिए, उसको ऊपर वाली पॉकेट में डाल सकते हैं।
So, please tell about yourself again.
Yes, so I'll give a brief introduction of mine. As sir has introduced me already, I'm Himanshu Nagpal, All India ranked 26 this time. And I put up from a town in Haryana, Hasi. So had a very middle class upbringing and then a normal school. And I scored decent in my class 12th from commerce, 97%. Then I got into Hansraj College. And then I was a good student there as well. In 2017, I graduated from BCom Honours. Then I came to the preparation of UPSC Civil Services Examination. And after 2 years, I'm at this platform, and I owe big part of my success to sir. I still remember I was a student who used to sit right at this chair in the very front row, ask many questions to sir, and at a time irritate him with my questions as well. And
I remember last year you came for clearing your doubts.
Yes, sir.
You were sitting for a long time. So Mr. Manish Goyal, he's a chartered accountant. So he thinks like a CA. Why you are giving so much time to one person? You are having sitting for 2 hours or so, or 1.5 hours.
Yes, sir, 2 hours.
You are having a long list of queries. But I know those who qualify, they are having these features. Similarly, Keshav Goyal, he was having long sittings. And if you are having long sittings, okay, that is... Those who are having many queries, that is not a negative thing, that is a positive thing. So many candidates shy away from queries, asking queries. Ask your queries.
You have paid money for it, you can ask queries, no problem.
Right.
Okay. And about the sitting part, I still remember, I had this problem that I couldn't sit for longer, I used to feel lazy. So I came to sir and sir told me, eat fruits, more of fruits, not carbs. So I thought that what this is a silly suggestion ki isse kya hoga, but once I tried it worked. So for sitting as well, I owe part of my success to sir.
Right. As a commerce graduate, did you feel competition with CAs?
Earlier I used to feel that they would have a leverage because of their such big hard work that they've done and such big knowledge that they have. But for this examination, it's actually a leveler. Like, I am a graduate and I'm sitting right here. And other toppers as well, then Ritika is
Ritika
a graduate.
Ritika also there. She then got
Abhishek,
330 marks.
Yes, sir. 330 marks in commerce that she got. And then Abhishek, he was my classmate in college. Abhishek Jain.
Abhishek Jain.
Yes, sir.
What rank he got?
111.
Right.
So I to now think that this exam is better for graduates itself. But this exam,
fresh graduates, those fresh who graduate. Have recently qualified their BCom are most suitable because ABCD level questions can be answered by them very well. What is cost of capital?
It's
how weighted average cost of capital is calculated? So those who have recently studied 11th standard book or basic book, they can answer it well. You know, you have to write at least 60% or 65% theory in paper 1. Right? Paper 2 is equal for everyone. And those who have recently qualified their BCom, they are good in HRM and other basic definitions of management also.
Yes, sir.
So they need not worry about...
No worries. Be confident about yourself. I remember I used to be very nervous ki kaise ho payega, ki chartered accountant se competition kaise ho payega, but it's very much possible. It's very easy in fact for you. Because you have this creativity and mind mein itna prejudice already nahi hai. No, for the, sorry for the chartered accountant friends, but... अगर आपके माइंड में भी है तो ब्रेक दैट, बी अ स्टूडेंट यहाँ पर, लर्न एवरीथिंग सर हैज टू टीच एंड अदर टीचर्स आल्सो हैव टू टीच, डोंट हैव दिस प्रेजुडिस कि यहाँ ये पढ़ा तो यही होगा. दिस एग्जाम हैज डिफरेंट रिक्वायरमेंट्स फॉर द आंसर्स, फॉर द वे यू लर्न, सो यू हैव टू बी अगेन अ स्टूडेंट यहाँ पर.
सो देयर इज अ मैसेज फॉर चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स, दे शुड स्टडी लाइक ए स्कूल गोइंग चाइल्ड, बिकॉज आई हैव सीन सीएज आर गेटिंग लेसर मार्क्स, दिस इज प्रूव्ड दिस ईयर. Okay, 15th ranker, he got 270 marks or so, 270 marks. That is Chaploth, I forgot the name.
Atirag
Chaploth, right? And Ritika, she got 330 marks. Gap of 50 marks, right? Okay, we will ask your strategy of paper 1, paper 2. How did you prepare paper 1? I'm sure you took coaching paper 2 only.
Paper 1 and paper 2 both.
Sir. Okay, you took coaching for both. Right.
Paper 2 I did in sixth semester of my college. And paper 1 when I came to Rajendranagar and in June the class started. So this same very same batch paper 1 I did. So for paper 1, first and the basic, most basic resources, those sir's books, all the manuals that he gave, and the past year question papers. You have to see the pattern the questions are asking, how theory questions are being made up, and the syllabus. Syllabus, you don't have to worry about the syllabus because sir would do all of it for you. And for paper 1, if you have in mind, you can do two things. Rely on sir's books, those yellow books, and the practical questions that he'll give in your classes. So when you come to the classes, and learn something, learn a new topic, go back to your house, your room, and practice some questions. Sir will give you the manuals, the pages that sir used to give in the classes, ki, come and solve, do that homework thing. So don't procrastinate it, ki baad mein kar lenge, do mahine baad ya paper ke pehle nahi ho paata hai. Do it very same day. And if you even come to the sir, he'll check it for you. And class mein jo test hote hain, unko bhi please dena. बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट होते हैं एंड एक्चुअली द वे यू लर्न की आंसर्स कैसे लिखना है उनके रिव्यू से इट विल हेल्प यू वेरी मच एंड फॉर
एनीथिंग एक्स्ट्रा यू स्टडीड इन पेपर 1 एक्सेप्ट बिसाइड्स आवर नोट्स
आई प्रैक्टिस्ड
मस्ट टेल वेरी क्लियरली बिकॉज़ इट इज इन देयर गोल ओके
आई विल टेक इट वेरी टॉपिक वाइज पेपर 1
राइट
ऑडिटिंग थ्रू एंड थ्रू सर्स नोट्स वेरी दे आर वेरी ब्रीफ एंड वही रिक्वायर्ड होता है सर्स नोट्स Then accounting may some portions of theory.
Right.
Accounting may there are some portions of theory because hamari I did very way back. So uske andar jaise rules of SEBI for buyback, rules of SEBI for sweat equity, these and all, maine Google bhi kiya tha, aur JR Monga mein bhi available tha kuch. To thoda theory portions utha liya tha. Practical. कोई एक रिसोर्स उठा लेना या तो तुम वहां से कर लो या यहाँ से कर लो यहाँ से करोगे बेटर रहेगा क्योंकि यहाँ बहुत सारे सोर्सेज के डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस इंक्लूडेड हैं द नोट्स दैट सर गिव्स एफएमए थ्रू एंड थ्रू यहीं से किया था
प्लीज स्पीक इन इंग्लिश बिकॉज़ मेनी कैंडिडेट्स मे नॉट बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड इट
श्योर सर राइट देन फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस अगेन सर्स नोट्स एंड अकाउंटिंग देन
कॉस्ट अकाउंटिंग
सर्स नोट्स
राइट एंड फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट
FM sir's notes.
You must have seen something extra.
No sir, FM none.
Right. And taxation?
Taxation again sir. Because taxation if you do from outside, there's so much to do. And sir, what sir does it, he makes it easy for you. So why to do such large resources? Because paper 1 mein, for an outsider, you'll think ki itna sara resource cover karne ke liye. But you have to make it small, lesser for you. And sir does it for you, so you have to just rely on him.
See, in paper 1, there are two things. One is theory, second is numerical. I'm having an approach, but what approach you adopted to have hold over theory and numericals?
First, I used to make theory. Theory ke basis pe, you have to predict the questions. In every chapter, what are the form of questions that could be asked in theory? Because in paper 1, you cannot ignore theory. It's 60% the paper is theory. And theory question, the best part about it is ki you can predict them very much, like accounting standards. There's this list of accounting standards and one or two accounting standards will be asked. And just as sir ki, the notes that sir will give on accounting standard, they're on the basis of flowcharts. So it's better to use those flowcharts in presentation of the answer. Wo ek to time bhi bachayega aapka aur better presentation bhi dega aur thoda attractive bhi lagega to the examiner. So you can just use those. Or just if FMA, if you're reading any chapter like dividend decision or capital budgeting, You predict the questions. Uske andar kya kya topics ke upar ek 10 markers pooch sakta hai ya 15 markers ka topic aa sakta hai. And
main kya kar predict? How to predict?
On the basis of topics, sir. The ek chapter ke andar ek topics hai ya past year ke question papers bhi utha
sakte hai. Right. Past year questions will help predict.
Like Walters approach poocha hai ya Gordon's formula poocha hai. To uske andar kya kya pehle mind mein hona chahiye. What I used to do. Har chapter ke aage ek page laga deta tha. A4 size ka aadha kaat ke page laga deta tha. Uske andar main likh deta tha. Ki theory mein ye topics mein ye questions mujhe karna hai. एंड जब रिवाइज करने जाता था आई यूज टू मेक श्योर कि पहले मैं थियरी का पार्ट रिवाइज करूं देन मैं प्रैक्टिकल क्वेश्चंस को प्रैक्टिस करता था
इंग्लिश प्लीज इंग्लिश
हां सॉरी सर
राइट नो प्रॉब्लम
इट्स नेचुरल टू मी
डेफिनेटली
बट आई विल मेक श्योर ओके देन
बट मेनी कैंडिडेट्स फील दैट ओनली इंग्लिश स्पीकिंग पीपल क्वालिफाई I had this phobia when I came to Delhi, 1994, that those who are good in English, those who are well-saved, those who are well-calmed, they be CA. I came from village. I broke all the inhibitions, right? In the class also, that's why my focus is Baniya type focus, understand concept. That will give you marks. When you present any answer, present like a professor. But when you understand something, understand really. Yes, numerical questions. How did you prepare numerical questions in paper one? Because there are a lot of questions. I'm speaking from students' mind, not teachers' mind. A lot of questions are there. You have to do practice in corporate accounting, a lot of questions. Cost accounting, financial management, income tax. How did you handle these number of questions?
So in practical questions, there are two things. The breadth of the questions and the depth of the questions. First, you have to cover the variety of questions. Ki you'll know ki corporate accounting mein bhi, if there's a chapter on financial statements, there are many type of questions. Ki iska kya treatment hoga? First, you know have to all the things. Ki iska kya treatment hoga, iska kya treatment hoga. Then about the practice of questions. Ki theory or practical mein, you can't be like theory mein sirf theory hoga, practical mein sirf practical hoga. If there's a theory question, you have to include some of the part of the practicals. Ek koi example doge, it'll make your... Because yahan par college mein kya hota tha, 4 ya 5 number ke question hai, yahan par 15 marks ka wo question hai. So it has to be worth it. Practical ka example doge, theory question mein, it'll only be good. 2-3 marks badega hi badega. Similarly in the practical questions. First, if there is an aspect, ki agar jaise 15 mark ka ek financial statement ka question pucha, sorry sir, again.
Particularly, yes, a question if asked on ratio analysis, particularly.
Yes, sir. If there's a question...
On final accounts, there will be least scope for writing any theory, but if question is asked on ratio, calculate current ratio.
So then after those calculation of ratios, you have to give analytical examples and analytical inferences out of those ratios.
If this ratio is high or ratio is low.
And then what... Sometimes even in the question asks for it, he gives us some suggestions about the ratios and how should we go about it. If there's not, still you should do it. Once you do start to practice, na, it'll come naturally to you.
That
you
I'm having different question. There are volume of questions in paper one, numerical questions, right?
Yes,
how candidates should handle such a large volume of questions? Should all the questions be practiced or few questions should be practiced? Or see the questions, see difficult part only. What was your approach?
First, in those notes, there's this ticks that sir gave. One tick, two tick, third, three ticks.
Tick marks, right.
Three ticks wala and two ticks wala, they are though you have to practice multiple times. Because there's something new in those and they are important. Either they have been asked in past or there's a chance who better than sir can predict for you, at least commerce and accountancy in civil services. So, at least for two ticks or three ticks, you have to practice multiple times until that gets stored in you. Ki when the question comes in the exam, it comes naturally to you. Ki isme kya karna hai? What do you have to do in that question? And then one tick wala, or if there's no tick, then you have to at least go there for once. And if there's any new treatment that you notice, I used to write above ki that in this question there's this, and I'll revise then. I'll not practice it much. Once or twice I'll practice. But I'll remember the treatment that has to be done in that question, or what is new in that question. But for two or three ticks, you have to practice multiple times. You have to actually absorb that question inside yourself. When that question comes in the exam or the test series, you have to answer it, because practicals, there's a scope to get perfect marks. If you add practical with some theory and practical, that answer is correct, and you go give all the treatments and all the
assumptions,
proper presentation, assumptions, clarifications, then you can get perfect marks, 15 out of 15 or 20 out of 20. There is very high.
This was your first attempt?
Yes, sir, first attempt.
Good. So, did you face any problem in paper 1? Paper 1 problems in examination hall?
Examination hall, yes, sir, I did face. Actually, my best part of the preparation was paper 1 of commerce and accountancy. Because in college as well, I had this very funny thing about practical questions, and I used to love those practical questions in classes as well as the home preparation. In test series, when I gave one test at the sir, because I told the reasons to sir, and then the test series I used to get very good marks, 165, 117 test series. And I had this...
You wrote two tests only.
But I used to give this Hitesh sir, no?
Right, right.
In that test itself, I got 165, the one I wrote at Rankers.
Right, right.
But in the examination hall, because I was very absorbed into paper one, And I had higher expectations from it. So what happened in the examination of the paper was not to my expectation. It was a bit difficult for me at once because this exam paper one was a bit different from what has been asked before. So I started to give more time to a single question that I have to do the exam very perfectly. In that manner, I could attempt only 220 marks of the paper. So that's one advice to you all, that in the examination hall, because you must be all aiming for 2020. So although it's a very early advice, but do not get over absorbed into something. If you can't get it, have a time for questions. Start to attempting questions in a perfect time limit that you as a student, now you'd think 15 minutes, 20 minutes bhi chalega. But wahan par you have to have time limitations. So start putting those time limitations down only. What used to happen in the class test, which sir used to give, people used to take, if the exam is for 15 minutes, 20 minutes, people used to take 30 minutes, 40 minutes in those questions. That as if the marks that they'll get there on those times, they'll get there. But it's not there. 15, 20 minutes, if there, use those only time.
So don't take extra time in the class tests also.
That's important.
So you face shortage of time in paper
shortage
one.
Shortage of time, yes.
Due to tough question.
Some tough questions and extra time, because 30 minutes I gave only 15 marks question of
natural statements.
I had to be wrong somewhere.
Okay. Let us, any query in paper one?
Any query?
We have covered some finance. Yes.
Some corporate accounting book I used, and only for some chapters, or theory part only. This buyback.
Sure, bonus shares, buyback bonus of shares. Yes. Books like J.R. Monga, they are very good with regard to buyback of shares. J.R. Monga is very good in all respects. So it is a very heavy book. From theory, it is very good. He puts everything about whatever concept is there. SEBI rules are there, guidance notes is there, Companies Act is there, everything is written. Right?
I referred to the past year question papers, then I saw ki they ask questions on SEBI's guideline on right issue, SEBI's guideline on this, SEBI guideline on that. So I saw if there's something, some part of it is not there in the book, I referred to it. And at times there's multiple questions, simple questions which might not be in the book, are there in that J.R. Monga book. So you can just see that if there's a possibility, this thing can be asked in the paper. Refer to the past year question papers, read it multiple times. Every time you finish any chapter or any book or any subject, go to the past year question papers, see if you have done enough for yourself that you could answer those questions. Practice those questions then, and maybe bring it to sir to see if there's a proper presentation of the questions.
Any other query in paper one? Right.
Any query for financial institutions,
yes,
or anything?
Let us do paper two. Paper two.
She had a query.
Yes, yes.
Any topic
Yes, I did not cover the, because of the time laxity, I did not cover the practical questions of amalgamation and internal reconstruction, but you should do that.
You're talking about preparation.
Preparation.
At preparation level, you skipped amalgamation absorption.
Practical questions of
amalgamation.
Yes,
because we were also skipping. So
yes,
you
sir,
followed
sir.
Our advice.
Yes, sir. But
question was actually asked, right?
Because now the pattern has changed. Now sir would also make you practice it, and you should also practice.
Yes, this year will take.
It was in our class. It wasn't a pattern. We follow a pattern, na, to make the best use of our time. So, in our time, practical questions on these topics were not asked. So
for 10 years, questions were not asked.
Yes,
since
sir.
2009 till 2016 or 17, questions were not asked. Numerical questions were not asked on amalgamations. Right. Let us come to paper two. What was your total approach of preparing paper two?
So paper two, for paper one, I did not refer much resources. For paper two, besides sir's book, these are the Bible that you have to add things on. Don't do much reading of the books, because paper two, if you'll know, you'll know. They would be there in the books. You just have to know the basics of it. Extra things you'll have to add. So make sure you put extra emphasis on first thinkers, because now it's not a general studies paper. It's a specialized paper. You have to be a bit practical about it. Give emphasis on thinkers.
Thinkers. On thinkers? They can purchase thinkers book?
No.
Thinkers in the books, right?
Thinkers in those books only.
I suggest purchase thinkers book. Prasad and Prasad. Thinkers book is there. I'll tell you the thinkers which are to be done.
then it's
Prasad and Prasad's book.
Yes, sir.
Right,
yes, sir.
Right. And this year we are suggesting thinkers. Previously we were not giving much emphasis on thinkers, but considering the type of questions asked, we recommend to purchase a book on thinkers, Prasad and Prasad. Thin book is there, around 120 or 150 page book is there. Right, right. Please
and then,
continue.
In theory paper 2, put very good emphasis on 10 markers. When you're reading a chapter, know what type of 10 markers questions could be asked from that. And in 10 markers, there's a very defined structure. In 20 markers, you first have to know what is the demand of the question. What are the sub-elements of the question and then answer on the basis of the question. But in 10 markers, it's just a very single word that you've been given. And on the basis of that word, you first have to define it, then OB or OT utility of that particular concept or any features of that concept. It's very simple. So make sure you get the very best out of the 10 marker questions. In 10 markers, you can get, in classroom, I used to get like 7 or 6 very good scores in 10 markers. So my extra scores, I had 166 in paper 2. So my extra scores in paper 2 were a contribution from the 10 markers question. So put a good emphasis on it. But even for 15-20, वहाँ पर भी if you are able to assess the demands of the question very well, what are the sub elements of the question, and then on the basis of the sir's notes and in the things that you've read, if you could answer it very clearly, even 15 marker, 20 marker, you can get very good scores. And about the resources in paper too, besides sir's book as I've already suggested and the thinkers books that sir suggested, whenever I used to go back and revise, I used to look for contemporary examples on that particular topic. What has been happening around that topic. For example, if you've been reading industrial relations, there's this very new term, that is new schemes that have been coming up by the government on Skill India. I used to relate it to it. And about what special thing in UPSC answers now, what happens, you have to make it look good for the examiner. It might not be that good, but you have to make it look good. So if you mention on a topic of industrial relations, what V.V. Giri has said, or what Mahatma Gandhi has said on a particular topic of industrial relations, it makes your answer look very legitimate and valedictory. And then if that's there, you'll get extra marks. So whenever you go back home, don't read that much on extra. But whatever you've read in the class, look for what's new in there. Some contemporary example or some diagram that is there, very good diagram in some management websites or even on Google. You'll find some.
Even Hindu also, there is opportunities,
yes,
page
sir.
In Hindu. Even today's opportunities page is having many things for OT, OB, HRM. There are 2-3 topics.
You don't have to, what gets wrong with this, ki when you read that Hindu page, what I've seen sir, with students, they start to make total notes of it. Look for contemporary examples only and add that in the notes. Don't make notes complete of that topic. Because that will be there in the book. It will be just one or two good lines that will be there in that topic. Even that is relevant for GS. So make sure you just take out those contemporary examples and some of the good lines or quotations that are there in that article, and you paste it in the, not the article, just the lines, you put that down in the book along with the topic.
Right, right. Any query in paper 2? You may not be able to ask query in paper 2 because you didn't see the syllabus. Still, any having concern in paper 2, you can ask.
Did you make notes separately?
No, 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 not much. Just for the things that I used to forget. So that I'll ensure ki exam se pehle, before the exams, I'll remember those topics. So for the 4 days prior to exam, I made 35 to... I converted all the 4 books and the material that I prepared for the paper 2 into just 35-40 pages. And I just revised those.
So you will get a synopsis of paper 2.
It's a synopsis. But now you don't need to do it. If you started doing now, it will be complete waste. You can only do that when you've done multiple tests, you've done multiple revisions. Only then you know the things that you've been forgetting. How can you know it now that the things you'll forget it later? So don't do it now. Just when you come to the classes, go back home, revise it very well, and the things I've suggested, you can Google it, look for some extra examples or even the Hindu page or some other book if you want to read. Like I read that C.B. Gupta and T.N. B.P. Singh and T.N. Chhabra.
B.P. Singh, T.N. Chhabra.
I didn't read it page by page. I just looked for if there's some new topic that is not there in the book that could be asked in those 10 markers. But I'm sure sir has been doing the revisions of his book. It must be very thorough now, but I read that as well. some extra reasons or some extra causes or experiments that I could know from that book. I read that for once, not page by page, just the chapters that are relevant for the paper, and in those chapters as well, what has not been covered in the classes. So you can buy that for a reference.
Right. Is paper 2. B.P. Singh, T.N. Sabra. The name of the book is Organization Theory and Organization Behavior.
OT and OB, simple.
Right. So now can we ask general questions, general studies? How did you balance your commerce and GS? Epic Center would be commerce.
You can ask GS questions later, but
yes.
Only this.
How did you balance commerce with GS? That is also a very important thing. No? How much time you gave to commerce? And how much time to GS?
So,
on daily basis also, on a long-term basis also, that is...
Every day until December, January. January...
2018.
January 18, yes sir. So, for you, it will be January 2020.
So, when did you start preparing?
I started in March 2017. Sir.
March 17.
Yes, sir.
Okay, March 17 to January 18, right.
Yes, sir.
Means for the 8-9 months. Right.
To in those 8-9 months, because reserve your 4-5 months because of the level of difficulty of your prelims examination. At least get that opportunity to write mains and commerce. So make sure at least 4-5 months you give for prelims. 4 months at least, because prelims is becoming very difficult right these days. So for before those 4-5 months, there's this gap of like you'll have this 7-8 months or 8-9 months. Every day, don't give too much of time for option, but every day make sure after coming home you at least revise the topics that sir has suggested, and class test ke liye make multiple revisions. Make sure don't give laxity to the class test. There will be a mirror, because I have personally witnessed it. They are a mirror, the answers that you write in those classes, they are a mirror of what you'll actually write in your mains. So make sure you take it very seriously, the class test. And every day, 2 to 2.5 hours I used to give to my optional. And what's best part about commerce is that monotony of GS once, abhi nahi lagega, now you'll not be feeling it because you're new to your GS, but after 3 or 4 months, you'll feel bored out of it. Then commerce is an option which is completely different. So it helps you in that, getting over that monotony of general studies and getting something new in your hand.
So if someone asks, what is your hobby? Reading commerce is my hobby.
I personally had not written that reading commerce is my hobby. But reading management articles is definitely a hobby.
Right. So you were giving around 5 hours to commerce, 2.5 hours in the class and 2.5 hours at the home. And you were giving 4-5 hours to GS.
4-5 hours.
50%, too much time to
yes,
commerce.
Sir. Because commerce, sir, helps you a lot in that. You don't need to actually go back and do that much. But for GS...
this is not praise session. This is.
But it's true, sir. If it's true, right, it's not bragging.
Right. Okay.
And then for GS, because GS, Kendra, you have to do your own hard work by yourself. Commerce, after prelims, for 40 days until the results were announced, I had completely done my optional very well. I had made those 40-50 pages that I told you about. I had practiced multiple tests, and with the classes that tests were used to going on, then I used to practice those as well. I used to, every day, I took up that past year questions, commerce and accountancy. This is a small thin book that you'll get from the market. From that, I used to practice at least 2 to 3 50-50 marks of questions. And it's, you have questions, so many questions to practice. Even at the end of the chapters, you'll find questions that sir has given to practice. So you can practice those as well. You can practice the ones available in the market. That is there. One or two questions you can practice now as well when the classes are going on. You know that you've done this chapter, you know this topic, practice it. And after prelims, though, you have to go and through with practice. So for 40 days, it was just commerce and accountancy. That I put my time into, and
40 days means up to result.
So result then after takes that I started days. My GS, and it's not that I have completely forgotten about commerce and accountancy. 2 to 3 hours still I used to give to commerce and accountancy to revise again and again, to practice again and again. So until the very last day of paper, I used to still give 1 or 2 hours to commerce. And because we had this time the privilege of having 5 to 6 days gap in commerce, so it could have been revision very, the revision went very easily in those.
Oh, let me ask another important question. Many candidates fail first attempt, second attempt, third attempt. So it was your first attempt. What do you say about those who are thinking about many attempts are needed?
No. I can't give any other example than me sitting right here. The very fact that this examination process is of 1 year. UPSC is looking for people who are very fresh to this cycle of examination. And this first attempt, if people don't clear, it's their own fault. You have to be very 100%. Don't, if you miss any topic, even 1 mark matters. That all of you know. Any topic could be of 15 marks, 20 marks. If you miss that topic for the sake of missing it, don't leave any topic. Don't leave anything which is there in the syllabus. If you leave any, it's your own fault. If you started to leave the topics, then even 6 attempts won't suffice. So you have to, if it's your first attempt, that 100% that you're going to give, even in your 6th attempt, that has to be in 1 attempt only, in that 1 year.
I want to ask this question. What do you think about those who have written 2 attempts, 3 attempts and didn't qualify? What fault they might have made?
To what I've seen, they become rigid. That exam, this examination needs some creativity in the answers. To what they do, what they've written, what they've understood, this I also witnessed with a classmate that was chartered accountants.
Yes.
In the classes. That they used to be like, "Arey, ye nahi hai. Class, wahan par ye padha tha." So that's true. But in this examination, the requirements are different. People must have knowledge. That's completely there. But this examination requires some new things which are very particular to this examination. So you have to learn those things. And for those who have not cleared in 2 to 3 attempts, what I've seen, they are very rigid to what they know. They're not experimental in their answers. They'll still write what's relevant, what was relevant for 3 years back and to what books they've known. This they'll still write, though they know not. What I've seen in myself, that I used to listen to my teachers very carefully, respect them, and listen to what they have to say about the requirements of this examination. But for those who had given 2 to 3 attempts, they were like, "Ki humko sab pata hai." It's not that. Teachers know more. So respect them and learn from them.
What I infer from your answer is, so those who are rigid about their strategy, that is harmful. Many persons, they focus on one area only, they become over-focused.
Yes.
What I have seen, those who are putting 2-3 efforts or attempts, they are obsessed about certain things only and they don't go beyond those things. Many candidates say, they are doing every question of past year. Don't do every question of past year. You are having limited time. See all the questions, must mark important questions and do practice of those relevant questions only or more important questions only. I can say 20%, 30% questions only. If someone is having a plan that I will cover 100%, okay, peaker chodunga isko, book ko, fir problem hoga, right? Okay, about essay, let us ask.
No sir,
okay,
yes. Just me add this, yes. Like I still remember, you'll have those topics of cash flow statement, funds flow statement. If you look in the regular books, you'll have hundreds and 200s of questions of cash flow and funds flow different. Now you can't sit and practice all those questions. You know that in every single question of cash flow and fund flow, you'll require 20 to 25 minutes at least. So look at the hours you'll spend there. So you have to be very specific, as what sir have said. Mark those important questions. Sir has done that for you, but you can also mark those important questions for revisions. So you have to make the optimum use of your time. And about essay, so I got 140 marks in my essay.
140 out of 250.
Right. So essay, it's the best part of at least mains. The best part is through this interview preparation that I'm sure about. But in mains, the best part is your essay, because you can be very free in that paper. You have your own area to look for, and you have your own ideas you can present. So I was very good at poem writing. So for border management, I wrote an essay. So I did write a small bit of poem in that. And वहीं पर ही हो जाता है. Like even I had a friend Ankur, Koshi, 37 rank this year, different optional. He also wrote that that a poem in that paper. So, whatever your strength is, people have their own strength and weaknesses. It's not that you'll all start to write poems in your paper. I had my strength. You have your own. Some people write anecdotes. Some people write contrasting instances. But what is similar about everyone is they have their own strategized way. That I had, for every topic, I made a list of topics in essay writing. That this topic might be as, this topic might be as. And for every topic, I had a ready introduction and conclusion made. That if this topic comes, then I'll write this as an introduction, some anecdote. For example, for women empowerment, I had this paradox already written that this rape cases are going on Kathua and this Unnao. And then on the other side of India, there's two different sides of India. One is that, and one is the number of women MPs and INSV Tarini, which is a whole women's sail ship going throughout the world. So those two different paradoxes I used to use. And some movies I used to watch, then I used to give those references to in the essay. And essay is a place which you have to make the life of the examiner easy and interesting. He needs to feel something new, a breath of fresh air that he's feeling through your exam copy. That you have complete freedom to make questions to the examiner in those essays. That why is this happening? You have complete freedom. You have to, cover the multiple dimensions that are there, but not make it rigid that you'll have to write political, social, economical, historical. You can use that dimensions wala area as well as the temporal, that you start from the past, you come to the present. But in every essay, give a very, very good way forward. Make sure you use the schemes, make sure you use the government programs. What's the government point of view in that? And Yojana magazine, there's this front page that comes in Yojana magazine of the editor. Make sure for various topics you give a read of it, for water, for electricity, whatever topics are there, they have a very good editor's desk page. And then there's other Yojana ke andar baki sab bhi important hai, but itna nahi hota, main to wahi padhta tha. Editor's desk page. You'll find very good introductions or conclusions in that. But in essay, don't make too much use of numbers and figures. Bahut technical ho jata then. But commerce people, they have a tendency to use numbers. So, wahan par thoda sa restrict yourself. 5 or 6 or 7 numbers are the max. Isse zyada, if there will be number in all line, it will become very technical.
Right. Any query on essay? Essay preparation? Might not have prepared, so...
I'll come next year if Salil invite me again.
Right. Definitely. Tell your... Yes.
This happens before mains only. You can't do it now, honestly. Because for essay, you need some content with yourself. If you, though you can write an essay now, there'll be, you won't know that you know, but you know something. You've been reading newspapers altogether. You've been reading for prelims. All this information works for essay as well. But now, at least build a content. And some other suggestion that sir might ask the question later as well, but I'll give it now. Ki for the very first time when you're reading things for general studies, don't make a segregation for prelims and mains or interview. Read it for the sake of a topic. That if you're reading ordinances or reading governor in polity, read it ki governor pad rahe hain. Iske liye nahi ki prelims mein, like this will be relevant for prelims or this will be relevant for mains. Do it later. But first understand. Then mugging up part is very, very important also. But that's for later. First understand the topics.
Now you can ask general queries.
Any queries you want to ask?
So these were structured queries from my side.
Current affairs. Although if you would have asked the question 2 years back, I would have said that current affairs magazine would suffice. But not now. Newspapers are very relevant. Given the type of questions being asked in the prelims examination, newspapers have become very relevant. Even the prelims question could be made out of an editorial. So read at least one newspaper very carefully every day. At least one and a half hours. But if you're having any discomfort in reading newspapers, because what happens for first timers, they don't know the static topic, so they can't understand the editorials and news mentioned in the newspapers. So if you're having that problem, maybe first complete your static, then push to newspapers. But at least some editorials or some news that you find is important. Or otherwise, you can go to Insights Daily Current Affairs that I used to go. go very carefully every day. And the questions, 5 questions they used to give every day. And IS Baba ka bhi, there's this 5 questions every day on current affairs that I used to do. And at the end of the month, any current affairs monthly, I used to refer to Vision IS monthly. And Vision IS mein monthly mein bhi kya hota hai? Like, if there's a scheme, know what's being asked in the paper about any scheme or any thing that is mentioned in the paper. Like, scheme hogi to ministry is very relevant. Know the ministry. Ab there's this, someone asked me in the last session, Honey India session hai. Or there's this scheme, Honey India mission. Uske andar, the name itself suggests you, it's for honey production. But you have to know the ministry. That's just relevant. Uske andar itne sare objective honge, uske features honge, that's not important for you. So that's, takes you to the past year question papers. You have to refer to them to know what to take out of the topics of current affairs. If you're reading a current affair, if you're reading any about index, for last 6 to 7 years, every year they ask 1 or 2 index. But what they ask? They ask only about the organization publishing it. For 1 or 2 important indexes like ease of doing business, they'll ask also the components, parameters on the which that. So you have to know, if you're reading a current affairs, what you have to remember. Maybe make notes of it for things which you're forgetting.
Yes. Other questions? Yes, very important query. How commerce paper will help in GS?
It will make your GS paper look interesting first. Because what happens in options like PSIR, geography, that they're, because of, they're doing that in general studies as well, they're doing that in their optional as well. But optional has to be very different. Their answer writing has to be different. It has to be technical because it's a subject, specific subject. Commerce mein problem nahi hoga. Commerce is different, GS is different.
There is no benefit of commerce in GS.
In economics, you'll find many benefits. In economics, in the
capital market, money market.
Capital market, money market, such question. This year, there was a question on LTCG and DDT. Straight out of budget, which you used to refer for the commerce option. You can find benefits, but there's no such topic straight of commerce and accounts.
So you can avoid boredom in GS. If you're having history optional, GS would become boring.
Boring for you. And again, what happens, you start to write GS answer in that history option. Of, because history wahan bhi padh rahe hain, history yahan bhi padh rahe hain. But yahan aisa nahi hoga. It will be technical, it will be general. Very straight segregation.
Right. Any other query?
In your interview, what were the questions asked from commerce?
Yes. What were the questions in interview?
Some
from commerce.
Were,
yes.
Some questions were, although the I still know the marks that I got was for something else. That I had this hobby of interior designing, so they asked me about design this room. And for 2 through 3 minutes, they were very good. But for interview, there was this question on government accounting system.
Government accounting, yes.
Yes, sir. Single entry.
Yes, system. Single entry system.
Single entry system and cash basis. So they asked me why it's not accrual, what's accrual accounting system and how, why not going towards accrual. And if you are the head of the organization, what will you do to make it accrual? This was one, and then there's some questions from economic concept like oligopoly kya hai, monopolistic competition kya hai. And then there was some questions on, I was asked one on that, CAPM model.
Okay, CAPM,
yes,
capital assets pricing model.
There was the ma'am which is sitting there, I thought she's from accountancy or commerce background only. She had very
right.
She asked me about how does beta works, how it is made.
Yes. In a restricted manner, I discuss capital market, share market, but I discuss it in a restricted manner. That is to the extent useful for you.
Sir will give you a total list of questions that are probable for the interview. That'll
for interview, we are having around 200-250 questions, so we'll give you at the time of interview.
Also, yes. It's very far-sighted view from now to think about interview. It's very different. And when it happens, make a group of yours. Because sir will make a group of interview. And I had a friend who is also, he was a college senior.
WhatsApp group will be there.
You can be around people and then think about the type of questions beside the list that sir gives. That
right.
Could be asked in the paper from commerce.
Any other query? Yes, yes. So the query is, are there questions from DAF?
All the questions are from DAF only. All the questions, every word in the DAF you have to fill very, very carefully. Like even a single word that you mentioned in the DAF, there will be questions from it. Your hobbies, your place of residence, your even your date of birth, if it's some relevant year or it's relevant date, they will ask. I still remember a friend, he did 9 November, so 9/11 ke baare mein poochne lage the usse. Any word that you mention in the DAF, you have to be like, a month you spend in your interview preparation, it's on DAF only. You'll make the list of questions that could be asked. If there is a hobby, like, manager bhara tha interior designing, I was like, theek hai, aata hai, but I had no technical knowledge about it. So, baad mein pata chala ki, I had to read books, I had to go to more houses, I had to meet interview designers to give those suggestions that I finally gave in the paper, in the interview. So, for every hobby or everything you fill in the DAF, do it very, very carefully.
Any other QSC? Yes.
So at what stage do you start making notes from the editorials? Because it's practically impossible to retain what you are reading on daily basis.
So the query is, at what stage you started preparing notes?
Notes from
editorial in newspaper. So you are studying Hindu. You were studying. You studied
studying Hindu.
Yes, yes.
Then for interview, I was studying 4 or 5 papers, but that's different.
When for interview, take care.
Interview, not now. Haan, for prelims and mains part, written part, okay. So for now, when you'll like by the month of October, November, I had at least done a basic of reading of all. I had an idea what are the technical words that are mentioned in the paper, in the newspapers. Then what happens in newspapers editorial is, if there is an important occurrence, like jab EWS economic welfare section ya RBI ka issue chal raha tha ya jab CBI ka, regularly 4 or 5 articles for a week or so come, but you have to have a page of what is relevant for you. You can't read everything and make notes every day because it's repetition every day. So for such important topics that are there in current affairs, you'll know ki a complete gist of it would be there in the current affairs magazine. So you shouldn't make notes of those, because they will be very thoroughly covered in the current affairs magazine with a very, give a reading of it, but don't make notes out of it. For very specific notes, for numbers and all, you can also use, if there's any statistics mentioned in any editorial, or there's some index, or there's some fund, or there's some new scheme that you see in the newspaper.
Those who want to link can link, no issue.
Use that.
Right. So others come forward. आगे सीटें खाली हैं आगे आजिए आप.
This one strategy out of it. If when you read an editorial, read it once, keep it aside, make your own interpretation out of that editorial in a half page, or even for the secure questions that come in the insights. I used to practice those. But you shouldn't start it now. Make at least one student like reading first. Give enough time for your understanding. Then start to do those practice or editorial note making. Only then it will be better. Otherwise, it will be time waste. Once at least. Later, at the later part of the preparation. But first, I used to go back home, read at least a chapter of Lakshmikant, some portions of the commerce, some portion of the history. Every day, I had this allocated time, which I'll give to those books and commerce. And then once it was done, once I had a basic idea about the preparation, about what's there in the syllabus, I started reading newspapers very carefully. Because earlier, if you'll have a GS classes, there you'll see people are highlighting everything, underlining everything, and then they'll two days later, they'll not know even one single news that they covered. You've been reading newspapers, do you even remember any single new editorial that you read? That's there. That will happen to you. That's happening to everyone. But after 3 or 4 months, when you'll have a basic idea about the syllabus and the preparation and the books, then start to make notes out of editorials. Because editorials may news hoti hai, but you have to cover an issue. Issue is relevant for you, and issue will only be asked in the paper. And issue you will find in the syllabus. Ki koi news aayi hai, it's relevant to a context of an issue which is there in the syllabus. And when you have covered the syllabus only, then you'll find the relevance of that news.
So, according to other queries,
we should first make the hold in the optional and the GS, then we should go for the newspaper.
Yes. Otherwise, for that time, if you're not able to, because you have this fear that we call it FOMO, that we're not reading the newspapers.
Yeah.
You'll have this. But for that part, because if I can suggest you to read newspapers, but I found it of no relevance for the first 2-3 months. Because I did not used to understand that. For starting about 2-3 months, when you once cover the syllabus, read Insights Daily Current Affairs and the magazine, monthly magazine of any, then you start to read newspapers very carefully.
So if we go through the headings and subheadings?
Headings, once you go through. What's happening around you, to know that.
In 1.5 hours, we just go through the overall
content. Not 1.5 hour. Like starting, if you, 1.5 hours, you give proper reading to the newspapers. 15-20 minutes for now, then if you start to read newspaper 2-3 months later, give 1.5 hours reading of then.
Because now at start, don't give much time to newspaper. Later you give, okay,
later
more
you
time.
Give this. Right. 1.5 hour, 2 hours.
Yes, your query?
Sorry, it's a bit
after
loud.
Prelims, when you were preparing for mains, in which month you stopped preparing, reading newspaper?
Honestly, I didn't read newspaper after my prelims and the mains time because I had all the news prepared, all the current affairs prepared. But for some things which are very important, and I had this idea ki this issue could be asked in the paper. For those I covered, for those days I used to buy the newspapers, but not every day. Because mains mein, it's very specific type of questions that are asked. In prelims, you have no idea, like, kahan se aayenge. But mains mein,
big issues are asked.
Issues are asked. Big issues are asked.
Right.
Yeah, try to. Matlab,
give reading important topics
reading,
only.
Give a reading of 15-20 minutes every day for time pass at least with a TE or something. But if you find some important topic which is big relevance for the paper, then at least read it.
Oh, you will be having many queries. I request you give your email ID so that okay, so that they can ask queries. Yes, this is Mark. So you can put your queries on this email ID. Himanshu.Nagpal08@gmail.com. Right.
So one last question.
Yes, yes.
Regarding the insecure, you
said secure, not insecure.
Sorry. What is secure? Like you used to write questions. Like from which time you started?
There's two ways to answer those.
Like there are 5 questions.
Every day they ask on the platform, and every month, and you'll get the gist in the market with the answers. So because starting with this secure is very, very good for those who have given one attempt and not able to qualify, because they need something new and something to practice. But for people who have just started, it's not of any relevance. So after pre, I bought the gist from the market of every month, because for every month they'll give this month me ye question secure pucha. So I bought that from the market and I practiced at home. So that you can do after your prelims. DLP.
ILP.
ILP,
sir.
So,
it's efficient, so otherwise
I'm like, it's also equally good, in fact, better, because at times, secure, what they do is ask questions for the sake of asking, but
yeah.
ILP, it's very good.
But they used to skip sometimes they used to post articles on CS after a few days. So,
doesn't matter much, you still
so
have to do
ILP
it.
ILP
is better. If you have to follow one, then ILP is better. But it's, you have to pay for it, now.
We have to sum up the session, and I'll take this opportunity to give a small reward, okay, to Himanshu. This is a portrait of Ma Lakshmi and Ganesh ji. So hope he get a lot of prosperity, success in the life ahead. Right. Besides this, there is a cash award of 11,000 rupee, right?
Thank you so much.
वीडियो बनाइए उसने
कोई हो एनीवन एल्स हैविंग फॉर
वीडियो So you can put your queries here.
I'll take 4 or 5 hours because immediately I can't answer, but I'll definitely answer any query of yours. I know the importance of doubts being cleared because I was at the same place, so I'll definitely try to answer it the best of my abilities.
Thank you, Himanshu.
Thank you, sir.
Nice.
हाँ हाँ सिलेबस उठाओ हर एक वर्ड